So as you can see, the need to change your personal statement from MD application to DO application becomes almost non-existent. What's going on, guys? Dr. Ryan Gray here for another episode here on the premed.tv channel. Thank you so much for joining me. If you are new here, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell button to be notified of more great videos here every week. Now, I've been getting this question a lot. What is the difference between the MD personal statement and the DO personal statement? Or asked another way, how do I change my MD personal statement for the DO application? Now, lucky for you, I wrote a whole book on how to write a personal statement, which you can find kind of anywhere where you may buy books. And let me tell you that that question changed a little bit, or actually the answer to that question changed a little bit within the last couple years, because the DO application changed the character count for the personal statement. And I actually have to update it in the book. I haven't done that yet. Historically, previously, before this change, the DO application was 4,500 characters, and that includes spaces. A lot of you try to count characters without spaces. That includes spaces and tabs and paragraphs, everything. It counts everything. 4,500 characters. The MD application, AMCAS, allowed 5,300 characters. So it was 800 characters for you if you are applying both to MD schools and to DO schools to try to figure out what you were going to do. Now, some students would take the path of writing a 4,500 character essay and submitting that same essay to the MD application. I didn't recommend that. Some students would write the 5,300 character personal statement for the MD application and then write a separate 4,500 character personal statement for the DO application. And I actually don't recommend that either. Some students, historically with the 4,500 character count personal statement, they would write the way that I would recommend, a 5,300 character essay and then cut out 800 characters from that essay. Now, the biggest question, that at the heart of all of the questions, is do I have to write a personal statement that is dedicated to osteopathic medicine? And I will tell you, no, you do not. Now, a lot of you out there may go, but it's osteopathic medicine. They want to make sure that I want to be an osteopathic physician. I understand that. And I will tell you there is a place for that. And I will show you where that place is. But it's not the personal statement. And I believe that the change that Acomas made with going to 5,300 characters from 4,500 characters for their personal statement proves my point. Going from 4,500 characters to 5,300 characters basically says, hey, we want more students applying to DO schools. We want to make it easier for you. Just submit the same essay to us. That's what they're saying when they increased their character count to 5,300. When you actually look at the prompt for the personal statement for DO schools and MD schools, the prompt is basically the same. Now, reading from my book on page 42 as it is right now, the Acomas prompt says, write a brief statement expressing your motivation or desire to become a DO. Okay, so they have DO in there. Okay, interesting. The AMCAS prompt asks you to use the personal comments essay as an opportunity to distinguish yourself from other applicants. Consider and write your personal comments essay carefully. Many admissions committees place significant weight on the essay. Here are some questions that you may want to consider while writing the essay. Why have you selected the field of medicine? What motivates you to learn more about medicine? And there's one other question in there as well. So you may think that Acomas prompt says, well, it specifically says, what motivates you to become a DO? And I will tell you, ignore that, right? It goes against all wisdom. Ignore it. They adjusted the character count to 5,300 characters. It's the same as AMCAS. They want you to submit the same essay. Where you distinguish yourself in the DO application is through the secondaries. And I'll show you some secondary essay prompts that kind of prove that point. I have a whole secondary essay database at secondaryapps.com, so you can see the secondary prompts that different osteopathic medical schools ask, and MD medical schools as well. And I went through about a dozen or so of them before I got bored, because almost all of them asked something specific about osteopathic medicine. Why osteopathic medicine? Why this osteopathic medical school? And I'll show you some specifics there. The personal statement in my mind, and talking to admissions committee members and deans of admissions all over the place, is an essay about what is motivating you to become a physician, period. Now, even with the DO application, what is motivating you to become a physician, period? It's the same essay for both applications. Where you can start to distinguish yourself on the DO application is through the secondaries. Now, let's look at some of those secondaries, and I'll show you how some medical schools are asking you to write about why DO medicine. So as I pull up Western University of Health Sciences secondary essay here, you can see that this is from the 2019 application cycle. It says, while shadowing a physician, what did the experience do to solidify your desire or ambition to become an osteopathic physician? It's right there. Why DO? Now, another school here, Midwestern University, Arizona secondary essay, asks, why do you believe that Arizona College of Osteopathic Medicine would provide you with the type of osteopathic medical education you are seeking? Again, it's an osteopathic physician question. This is where you can put your desires for osteopathic medicine, right here in the secondary. And then you can tailor it to the school as well. Now, Idaho College of Osteopathic Medicine has a little bit of a different secondary application. They have a mandatory question that you have to answer about why did you apply to Idaho College of Osteopathic Medicine. Again, you can, very similar to the Arizona College of Osteopathic Medicine, you can put in why osteopathic medicine and then why Idaho as well. But then they ask you to answer one of the following two questions, and it said, without using the word holistic, which is very cliche, and I'm glad they actually tell you, just don't tell us holistic. I'm sure they're tired of hearing it. They say, describe in your own words, what is osteopathic medicine as you understand it? Why osteopathic medicine? Right there. What is it? And then you can talk about your desires for it as well. The personal statement can be exactly the same for both applications. In the secondary essays, the far majority of osteopathic schools will ask you about osteopathic medicine in the secondaries. Another school here, Toro University in California, asks, please describe the personal characteristics you possess and the life experiences you have had that would contribute to your success at becoming an outstanding osteopathic physician. YDO. That is what they're asking. They're asking for qualities that you think about, and then why do you want to be a DO? Michigan State University College of Osteopathic Medicine. They ask, why are you applying to Michigan State College of Osteopathic Medicine? There you go. YDO. You have that right there. William Carey, same thing. Really long secondary essay here, but it breaks down into YDO. You have that opportunity on your secondary essays almost at all schools to write about YDO. So as you can see, the need to change your personal statement from MD application to DO application becomes almost non-existent. You don't need to change it. With the huge change, again, within the last year or two, I think it was last year as I'm recording this, the DO application changed from 4,500 characters to match the MD application at 5,300 characters. And that tells me that they just want you to apply. Now, you could be a cynical and go, well, of course they want you to apply. That's more money for them. That's true. And there are more DO schools opening, and they need students applying to those schools. And so they want the best of the best students applying to DO schools as well. And one of the barriers, potentially, maybe they've done some research, they did some surveys, whatever it is, one of the barriers, potentially, is, well, I don't want to write a separate essay. I don't want to have to write or figure out how to cut 800 characters out of my essay. And so they changed the character count to 5,300. It's the same essay length. Use the same essay. Use the secondary applications, the secondary essay prompts, as your place to differentiate and talk about why osteopathic medicine. And as it said in the Idaho College of Osteopathic Medicine secondary app, don't just say that you are interested in holistic medicine. All good physicians practice holistic medicine. The DO world does not own that trademark. All good physicians practice holistic medicine. So dig deeper than that when thinking about osteopathic medicine and what that means to you and how potentially you want to integrate that into your practice. Again, if you want some more information and advice on how to write a personal statement, check out my book, The Pre-Med Playbook, Guide to the Medical School Personal Statement. I have a whole series on the Pre-Med Playbook, the interview, the MCAT, the personal statement, and the Pre-Med Playbook Guide to the Medical School application is coming soon. Hope you enjoyed this video. Again, subscribe if you have not already. Hit that bell to be notified of more great videos. And don't forget to check out our videos every day, almost every day, every week. We are releasing more great videos for you. We're excited to start recording, hopefully soon, a success story series, very similar to application renovation, where we talk to a student about their application on why they didn't get in. I have a bunch of students I have lined up to do a success story looking at an application for students who did get in. And it would be interesting to see what is different about those students' applications and why they got in. Was there something in their application, or was it just luck? Do the applications look alike? And so I'm excited for those. Again, subscribe so you can be notified of those as well. Hope you have a great week. We'll see you next time here on premed.tv.